Hello, everyone. This is Cody Lee of BlackCatBooks.org, author of Eye of the Dragon, Cruel and Beautiful, Rabbit Hole Lore, and Vray, and the upcoming Jaw of the Dragon. I've been talking very positively about Platinum Games in the past couple of weeks. Ever since Bayonetta 3, I've been over the moon about them and talking about them like in no uncertain terms, like I used to back in 2013-2014 period. And a lot of people have been confused as to why. A lot of people have been like, don't understand like my sudden shift in opinion towards Platinum, and I don't exactly begrudge you for that because I don't exactly begrudge you for that because I haven't talked at length about what's been happening with Platinum Games. I have neglected, unfortunately, to talk about like the situation there and how it's changed and like how things seem to be evolving there. I really, really should have talked about this a long time ago, but unfortunately, I'm so busy, you know, trying to become rich, working, like playing games, enjoying my life, that like a lot of minor subjects like this pass me by, unfortunately. So I'm gonna have to take some time today to really talk about this. So, of course, like in 2019, Platinum launched their Wonderful 101 Remastered campaign. It was like the worst thing ever. It completely killed the company in my eyes. It was a complete disaster. Like they asked for Kickstarter money for a port. And of course, like that port ended up bombing on all major platforms. And Platinum had, for the past, the next couple of years, went through this phase of just putting out like absolute garbage. They put out like, you know, Babylon's Fall earlier this year. And it wasn't until Bayonetta 3 came out where it felt like they've been making a turnaround. They can still produce good games. And one of the things that's changed in the past couple of years is that like the CEO has stepped down and like has been replaced by someone else. So I think the guy who was talking about like live service games and microtransactions has been replaced by someone who actually wants to continue making action games. And not only just continue making action games for Nintendo consoles. That's been a major, major reassuring thing for me. Like post Bayonetta 3 is that like everyone at Platinum is like very happy with Nintendo and wants to continue working with them in a close capacity. And that is all I really needed to hear, because Nintendo is the only company in the industry that actually respects Platinum's talents and have actually brought out anything good in them since Mikami left. You know, like the Wonderful 101 is one of the best games ever made, right? People don't like to admit it. People don't talk about it, but it is true. So considering like the situation and how things have changed, I am willing to give Platinum the benefit of the doubt, because you know they haven't done any more Kickstarters, they haven't produced any more like multiplats, they haven't like shafted Nintendo in any meaningful way. They put out a really good game in Bayonetta 3, and they're saying all the right things. So I personally think Platinum is on the verge of making a comeback. Like obviously, I would want them to be like bought out by Nintendo and controlled absolutely by them. Like I still feel like Hideki Kamiya should not be like in charge of anything other than like game development. He's like a vice president there. Like, why just have him make video games? I feel like there's a lot wrong with Platinum, but like with certain changes in management there, like Nintendo like seems to have placed a plant there. Like a former Nintendo Europe guy like relocated to Platinum. So as a CEO, I think, like some major higher up. So that guy might be like pushing Platinum to make more action oriented like Nintendo Switch exclusives. So we might actually see some like really good, exciting Nintendo Switch exclusive stuff in the next couple of years from them, right? And obviously, you know, Bayonetta 3 was great. Bayonetta Origins looks great. And like, obviously we don't know what's in the future for them after that, but I am optimistic that we may actually start to see a good game from them again. I've been seeing nothing but positive signs, and I think Platinum might actually make a glorious return to form.